That egg all down there.
Oh, shut up, will you? Some very famous names in the music industry. And joining us this morning is one of the band's frontmen, James Raine, and the brains behind the whole project, Simon Hussey. Good morning, James.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Excuse my partner, will you?
That's okay. I can't
see any egg there.
No, I just had a little bit of egg.
Oh, that's it. Stick up for
I was
him.
Having a bit of egg for breakfast. How are you?
Good, thanks.
Congratulations.
Thanks very much.
This is a knockout, isn't it, your single?
Yeah, it's going very well.
Is that the first time that you've worked with Daryl?
It's the first time, actually, I've actually done...
Daryl Braithwaite.
Daryl Braithwaite. Sang with him, yeah. I've kind of written songs with Simon for Daryl.
So you got there's Daryl, Julian Lennon, yourself, the three of you.
It's a guy called Jeff Scott, an American guy.
Oh, that's right.
Oh, I suppose we can't mention Peter Mitchell, can we?
No, don't mention Peter Mitchell.
How did this all happen, Simon?
Well, I think I've basically worked with Daryl and James for the last 5 years, so... And we've always made, you know, it's been my idea to sort of get together and make an album of music that's not either James Raine album or a Daryl Braithwaite album.
Like a travelling Wilburys,
sort of. Yeah.
But it's just getting the talent that's in Australia.
Yeah. And just making an album with no rules really or boundaries. So.
Did you have to hard sell to get the money to do it?
Not really. I mean, with those two guys on, it was pretty easy because the record company thought, oh, here we go.
Plus, so, you've made Sony a bit of money yourself. I mean, you produced some pretty successful records.
Yeah, I think the thing about, though, we didn't really want to make it a supergroup type album, deliberately put it together like that. So.
Well, did you do James Blundell one?
No, I
did that one, actually. That was my first little shot at that one.
Oh, you did that, did you?
Yeah, it wasn't hard. I just sat in the big chair and said to everyone, "Well, what do you think?" And they'd say, "Well, I don't know, what do you think?"
Yeah. So, who wrote the songs on this one?
Myself and Jeff Scott, who's the American guy, who's played on both of James's albums.
He's a guitarist, isn't he?
Yeah, and he's a good singer too. Yeah.
But where do we know him from?
From James's first band, actually. James's first solo tour. Mm.
Right.
And where'd you get the name Company of Strangers?
Well, it's actually a song that James and I wrote for his last album, Electric Digger Dandy. And it's basically just a play on words, like we're all friends, we're all strangers to working together on the one record.
Yeah.
So.
Right.
Pretty simple. Yeah.
We got a clip
of this. Have a look at this. This is the Motor City clip. Is that you on the motorbike?
Yeah, Harley.
On the Harley. Is that yours?
No. I borrowed it for the day. I was actually a little bit nervous because the guy that actually brought it round there, he's sort of looking at me in the corner of the eye going, "You touch my bike." But he was really good, actually, so it was fine.
Where was the clip filmed? Where'd you do it?
Just in Port Melbourne, just in the studio.
Yeah?
Because all that industrial stuff is, what do they call it, chroma key?
No, chroma key.
So we're playing, standing on boxes and stuff, and it's just going on behind us.
You're a real good rock and roll singer, aren't you? You love rock and roll, don't you?
Yeah.
But I just want to
get into it.
I find the older you get, so the more I get into it.
Yeah, I'm like that.
The more you kind of lose yourself.
Now, listen, you've worked with James Blundell, now Dave, who's next?
Who am I going to work with next?
James Raine. You're going to work with himself.
You work with Swan. I don't know, yeah.
But will you keep doing stuff like... I think it's great, because they do it in America.
Yeah.
People will team up for a duet, and we've never done it.
Yeah. No.
The only one I can remember is John and... And they did that with
John
a girl.
Farnham.
Yeah, John Farnham and
Colleen Hewitt.
Daniel Gahar.
Yes.
The communication song.
Yeah.
Communication?
So you have to choose a girl.
There's been a couple of things suggested, I like it to do it. It's a great thing to do. I wouldn't want to make the rest of my career now being Mr. Duet, you know, because I've got
Mr. Duet.
To do it, of course, you know.
That's a good name, Mr. Duet.
Listen, what about Julian Lennon? How much has he had to do with it?
Well, the Julian Lennon thing came about. Exactly. Hopefully, he's going to have a lot. No, that happened. He was out here for the ARIA Awards at the beginning of the year.
He's lovely, isn't he?
He's a nice guy.
Yeah.
And the executive producer.
Close personal friend, that's right.
Yeah, well, he will be hopefully next week.
So he's had absolutely nothing to do with
it. Something going on here. He's not on it yet.
No, he's going to be on it. Actually.
He made the coffee.
Yeah. That's right, he's Orange Boy.
Come on, there's a story there. What's happened? He hasn't actually been out and he does nothing on the Reddit.
No, not actually as we speak right at this particular point in time.
But he's very interested in the project.
Very, very interested. In actual fact, the executive
producer. He's going to be on it.
What, he put
on
back
the
up vocals
yeah,
later?
Finish the album.
Yeah, no, lead vocal no, on, a, on a song.
Nearly.
We're getting there. No, actually, it is going to happen, but I think we're going to have to go to America to get it done. He originally was going to come here, but that's...
Go right to his house.
He's knock on his door, excuse me.
The first time.
Where are you, Julian? Where's he live in the States, is he?
He's in LA now, yeah.
Yeah. Do you have similar music taste you too?
No, not at all.
You don't?
Oh.
Well, what are
yeah,
you
Yeah, sometimes.
In?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, Simon's into more English stuff and I'm into more kind of American stuff.
When you switch off at home, you put something you like on. What sort of music do you play at home? Or don't you play any?
No, I do. I put on anything from Mendelssohn and Brahms through to, you know, The Clash.
Oh, I love those. They were a great group.
They were the Mendelssohn and Brahms.
Yeah,
they were a duet.
Listen, Simon...
Not very French list of a morning.
Listen, where did you... What was the first record that you produced?
Del Braithwaite's Edger.
That was the first record?
The first record, yeah. I'd done a lot of songwriting with James prior to that.
Yeah.
But that was the first production thing I did.
So did you play in a band? I like to know how people get started.
Yeah, well, actually, I started playing in James's first solo tour band, which is where I met Jeff Scott, who's the other guy.
Right.
And then did Del Braithwaite's record after that. So.
Gee, that for a first record that you did well, didn't you?
Well, thanks.
Oh, it's fabulous.
I mean, no, it was the sort of thing with that sort of record, we went in there without any preconceptions of how it was going to be.
Yeah.
Because trying to make a comeback thing, I think, is always hard to expect it to do something. And I was unproven, and, you know, for Daryl it was something new, so I was really pleasantly surprised it did so well.
So when you get Julian finally in this studio...
Yeah, which is going to happen.
...and you get it on the record, what's next for you?
I'd actually like to get into film music.
Yep.
Because I'm doing a bit of sort of pop
Sally.
Stuff the last couple of years, but yeah, I'd like to get into film stuff. I don't know, it's going to be difficult in this country to do that, but yeah. Are
you sure you've actually made this record?
Yeah, it's made.
Try and play
You're
it,
sure?
if it doesn't work.
Oh, there's nothing on there.
No, what's it say?
Yeah, it's got writing on it.
Yeah, it's not the same
What's it say, Way Out West or something?
It's shown a lane or something.
Yeah, it is. Is it? Walk away.
It's like when you get gold records, you know, I want to play one of those things.
John Farnham's first gold record from an album was Gladys Moncrief, the old musical comedy star.
Yeah, paint it over.
Yeah.
Sprayed over.
Mine was Perry Como.
Yeah. You know, I've looked at some of mine, yeah. And
many
it's got... Well,
yeah,
well,
yeah.
Well, tracks on it.
But you have got how many gold?
A few.
Platinum?
Yeah, a few platinum.
Yeah, yeah. Beauty.
Yeah.
Now listen,
this
what about this?
This will go platinum easy, won't it?
Well, I hope so.
Is it going to be released overseas?
Well, they're talking about it, aren't they?
Yeah, they are talking about it. Yeah, the English are interested, but yeah.
It's one of those things, you know, record companies always go, it's going to be huge in the States, you know.
They have
you kind
to
of,
do that.
Yeah, they
do
it. You know, they always give great meetings.
Is it hard? Is it hard to get play on American radio?
That's such a loaded question. For some people, it isn't. But I think, yeah, unless you're there in their face or unless you have really strong representation there, yes.
It's hard business.
Unless you fit a certain format, because it's so formatted now, American radio.
Yeah.
I mean, we moan about, some people seem to moan about radio here, but in America it's so tight.
Really?
Mm. You know, unless you conform to a really strict.
Plus, don't you have to tour and be seen and.
That's what I mean. You've got to be there in their face the whole time.
Definitely be there.
Now, listen, you're married to his sister?
That's right.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
So this is a family affair. What's he like as a brother-in-law?
You have to think about it?
No, he's good, actually. I mean, it's sort of weird, really, because we've worked together since 1984.
Mm.
And I sort of really met Elizabeth through that relationship, so it's sort of... It is.
So you have to say thank you,
David, right?
Yeah.
Really?
You got any Billy Dish?
One on the way, actually.
Have you?
Yeah. Oh, that's lovely. So, how long to wait?
May. Quite a long way.
Oh, right.
It's a good time to wait, I think, to get used to the idea.
Now, what's the album called when it comes out?
Just Company of Strangers.
The Company of Strangers.
Yeah.
And Julian Lennon will be on it, won't
he? I swear he will be on it.
Good idea, James and Simon. Thanks,
Thank you.
Congratulations on a fabulous single.
Thanks,
James Wright, Simon.